Hi guys, this is Sanchit Sharma. In every religion, there are some mantras, incantations, hymns, chants that catch fancy of followers, providing solace and comfort to them. For Hinduism standpoint too, there are some mantras and chants which have held significant importance and considered to provide great merits to those who have chanted them with full faith. Chief among them are Gayatri Mantra, Aditya Rudram Stotram, Vishnu Stotram, Hanuman Chalisa, and Mahamrityunjaya Mantra. There is one common thread in these five mantras, which is possibly the reason why people have caught on to them in greater frenzy than others. From their core intent point of view, all these hymns are aimed at addressing the most basic and carnal weak link that drives our thoughts, words, and deeds, either directly or indirectly. That is fear. From the day we are born, whatever we do is fundamentally a derivative of fear. Fear of death, fear of losing things, people dear to us, and fear of failure of any form. All efforts of man are towards conquering these fears. These mantras have been powerful tools for human beings in overcoming all these fears. Mahamrityunjaya Mantra, by definition, protects us from our deepest fear, that is fear of death. Scores of articles and deliberations have been done ruminating over each word of this mantra. But in this video, we shall aim to simplify some of the core concepts and help get a sharper perspective of this mantra. So the mantra is Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushti Vardhanam Urva Rukmev Bandhanam Mrityor Mokshiya Mamrita. Which means, I worship that fragrant Shiva of three eyes, the one who nourishes all living entities. May he help us sever our bondage with samsara by making us realize that we are never separated from our immortal nature. In Hindi it means, Hum tri netradhari Shiv ki aradhana karte hain, jo apni shakti se sansar ka palan karte hain. Unhe prarthana hai ki ve hame jeevan ve mrityu ke bandhan se mukt karein और हमें दिखा दें कि हम कभी भी अपनी अमर प्रकृति से अलग नहीं होते हैं. सिंपली पुट, मंत्रास आर वाइब्रेशंस और साउंड वेव्स. ईच वाइब्रेशन कैरीज इट्स ओन स्ट्रेंथ एंड डिपेंडिंग ऑन द प्लेस, टाइम एंड सर्कमस्टांस. इफ यू वर टू ड्रॉ अ पैरेलल टू म्यूजिक, व्हिच इज आल्सो अनदर फॉर्म ऑफ वाइब्रेशन एंड साउंड वेव, वी कैन रिलेट दैट सम कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ वेव्स have a deeper impact on us than others. As much as Tansen was said to have conjured rains just by singing Meghrag, much as Raag Todi is played specially on Shehnai in every single wedding to express both deep joy and deep sorrow, the consistent feeling of patriotism one always feel when listening to Raag Desh is nearly the same way. Mantras are inherent sound waves that generate unique vibrations, enhancing individual and collective conscious and subconscious experiences. The Vedas extols Mananat Trayate Iti Mantra, which means the repetition of which leads an individual to overcome trials, tribulations, attain the state of equanimity. This is the aspect which makes mantras far more powerful than songs. So, there are three interesting stories in connection with the origin of Mahamrityunjaya Mantra. The most common one is connected to Rishi Markandeya. A child, He was advised to pray to Lord Shiva to prevent his premature death, and during the course of worship, Lord Shiva revealed this mantra to him. Another story is in relation to Shukracharya, the spiritual master of demons. Lord Shiva is said to have revealed these mantras to him. Another narration relates to the part of Rig Veda, where a portion is said to have been composed by Maharishi Vasishtha and hence attributed to him. Mantras are nothing but eternal truths which were discovered by rishis who contemplated on specific aspects of life and living. These truths will continue to exist with or without humans or life itself in the exact same way as gravity will continue to exist with or without life. I hope you like this video. If you have any suggestions, please put them in the comment section. Goodbye. See you again.